Allahu 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 Allah Allahu 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 Allah Allahu
Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu Allahu There was an author who was writing a book near the seashore. And as he was writing a book, he saw a small kid. The kid was picking up starfish from the beach and he was throwing it back into the ocean. This author was intrigued. He went to the kid. It's a small kid. He went to the kid and touched him and said, "Son, there are thousands of beaches in this world. There are millions of starfish which die on the beaches. What difference does your effort make?" Because the starfish, once they come to the beach, they can't go back, they die there. So the kid did not answer. He looked at the starfish in his hand, looked at it, threw it far into the ocean and said, "It made a difference to that one." This few words, I'm sure, made an impact to you, right? Yes? It made an impact to me and changed my life. This one story. So that's the power of something called as vocabulary. So I'm going to talk a little about, in the next 1 hour plus, I'm going to talk about something very profound which is sort of missing in the entire education system, not just the Islamic schools. It's the entire education system which misses this. When we talk about communication, when we speak about communication, what comes in our mind? What comes to our mind? Anybody? Just shout out, what comes to your mind when I say communication? Okay, verbal, what else? Written expression, what else? Anybody, sisters, you can shout.
Body language.
Sorry?
Vocabulary,
what else?
Body language.
Body language.
Effective communication.
But nobody usually segregates the communication in two formats. The most sought after, the most trained, the most, you know, talked about communication is our external communication. The expression, the way we talk, the way we present ourselves, the body language and stuff like that. You go to any corporate, any institution, most of the programs are conducted on how to stand, how to stance, how to talk, how to use your words. But nobody addresses the more powerful communication, which is internal communication, which requires more training, which requires more conscious efforts to tweak and, you know, understand what are the structures, because communication happens in constructs. For the people who handle languages, you understand that the communication is exactly like this building we are standing on. You know, you have a foundation, then you've got pillars, then you've got bricks, and you've got everything around it which makes this a sane structure for us to be here comfortably. If this was not sane, we wouldn't have come here, right? Exactly like that, in our nervous system, and this is physical, this is not something which is not defined. This is defined, this is physical. We have internal communication running all the time. As I speak to you now, you speak to yourself. As I'm talking to you, you're at that speed, you're able to comprehend, and you're speaking to yourself and trying to validate what coach is telling. Does it make sense? And only when it validates, you probably nod, you say yes, or you probably reject, right? So I'm going to talk a little on that, because that is something important we need to build our community with, especially the younger generation. They are following what? The trends which are predominantly there. I don't know how many of you have heard this. This is out of the syllabus. I didn't plan it. Just came to my mind now. How many of you have heard about this word boring? Boring. You've not heard boring? Are you hard to try? Itna kanjusi kyun kar rahe? Saturday morning, I want you to interact with them. I'm not a teacher here. I'm zero at teaching. I'm trying to be interactive. I'm half as learned as most of you here, right? I'm just facilitating. So put up your hand if you know the boring word. Can you translate boring into any other language? Bore. I challenge you. There is no equivalent of this word in any language. I challenge you. And boring, when we were kids, did you ever have this word bore? Did you ever think about this word? Bore ho raha hai. खामोश बैठते थे, आराम से बैठते थे, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं था, है ना? अभी खामोश बैठ नहीं सकते. ये वर्ड को The marketing industry has introduced one word and changed the entire buying strategies, thinking strategies and habits of the entire world. Word. आप ट्राई कीजिए किसी कोई लैंग्वेज में ट्राई कीजिए नो लैंग्वेज हैज दैट वर्ड एंड देयर इज अनदर वर्ड कॉल्ड एडिक्शन हमारे जमाने में एडिक्शन होता तो क्या होता एडिक्शन व्हाट इज एडिक्शन टेल मी व्हाट इज एडिक्शन सिंपल डूइंग समथिंग अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन नॉट बीइंग एबल टू गेट रिड ऑफ इट करेक्ट दिस इज एडिक्शन टुडे व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एडिक्शन इफ यू आर एडिक्टेड टू समथिंग वन सिंगल थिंग पीपल टेल क्या यार तेरे को कुछ भी नहीं आता The younger, I'm talking with the generation you and I are dealing with. The generation you and I are dealing, we need to be understanding their reality of the world, not ours. If you need to get to them, we should understand their, we should speak their language. Correct? How many of you have heard this word swag? Kab tha bhai dictionary mein swag. Have you heard this word? If you have not, you should really read these dictionaries of these younger ones. Because you understand what happens. You live only once. YOLO. सुना है? ये सो अपडेट नहीं रहेंगे, तो our education system will be outdated because we are not matching them. And then this, the kids will tell, आप लोग हमारी दुनिया नहीं समझ सकते. Have you heard this? Have you heard your own children telling you? My children tell me, Abu, you're too outdated. Come on. I don't know what you speak on the stage. Sometimes it's Greek and Latin to me. But are you with me now? Yes. No. मेरे को सुनाई कम देता है. So I want answers, please. That will keep me going. So what was I talking about? Addiction. आज का addiction क्या है? आप भी addicted हैं. आपको नहीं मालूम है. I'm introducing you to something. हाँ, what is that? Mobile. Mobile is not the. That's the means. The end is something else. The end is called variety addiction. Biscuits कितने होते थे हमारे ज़माने में? दो वैरायटी ग्लूकोज क्रैक जैक कुछ ऐसा 50-50 कुछ रहता था ना आज यू एंटर अ शॉप यू आर सो कंफ्यूज थाउजेंड्स ऑफ वैरायटीज ऑफ बिस्किट्स करेक्ट आर यू अग्रीइंग टू मी सो वी ऑलवेज नीड टू हैव समथिंग न्यू इवन यू नो फॉर दैट मैटर एनीथिंग यू टेक वी आर नॉट सैटिस्फाइड वी आर नॉट कंटेंट एंड वी आर बैटलिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ सिस्टम कैन यू बिलीव इट व्हिच इज बिल्ड ऑन व्हाट आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू वोकैबुलरी कंस्ट्रक्ट्स एक वर्ड वोर हैज चेंज्ड द होल वे ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ किड आर यू विद मी ऑन दिस ओके सो यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस आई एंड यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस चेंज सो वी हैव टू बी वेरी कॉशियस ऑल द काइंड ऑफ कल्चर वी आर गोइंग टू बिल्ड इज जस्ट नॉट अबाउट टीचिंग द कुरान एंड द हदीस इट्स मच बियॉन्ड दैट बिकॉज कुरान इज अ लिंग्विस्टिक मिरेकल बिकॉज इट्स वोकैबुलरी इज सो पावरफुल राइट इट्स एन एंटीडोट टू एनी काइंड ऑफ इल That's how I would look at it. It's an anti-virus to anything which is wrong, right? So powerful. So we have had this experience of change for you and I. But can you imagine what are the pillars of vocabulary our institution is established? I was a part of an organization, IT organization. We had an issue. The issue was, and this is a predominant issue in all the IT organizations. The issue is people come and they are committed to work for 8 hours, correct? But they end up working effectively only for 3 hours. You can check it out. आते हैं लॉग इन करते हैं 2 मिनट जाके सिस्टम ऑन करते हैं सिस्टम ऑन होते ही थोड़ा थकान होती है तो फिर उसके बाद क्या करते हैं they go for a cup of coffee and then they have a chat and then they come back and then they open their social media and some companies have locked it but a lot of smaller companies can't do that so effectively 3 hours and the work is at a very slow pace So when we engage with such organizations, what we do is we find out what is predominantly the fashionable culture of that institute or the organization. Likewise, you can extrapolate whatever I'm saying to your institution. What is the culture? The culture of any organization is the reflection or the shadow of the leader. If the leader or the management do not have in practice a culture, no matter what you say, let's do an experiment. Let's do it. Can you all lift your hand up like this? Make it like a butterfly. Make it like a butterfly. And bring it close to, do exactly as I say. Bring it close to your face. Bring it like this. Hover it around your face. And bring it and settle it on your chin. All are on the cheek. I said jinn. Only a 3-4. I said jinn, not cheat. You did what I did. You didn't do what I said. This is a reflection of kids. You know, kids, the management, the teachers, everybody will copy what the top brass does, not what they say. So our saying and our doing both jana mismatch. So why? Because we have not set bulleted culture. What is bulleted culture? We had this issue in our organization where things were not happening fast. So what we did? We created an annual event. Okay? For annual event, ko brand kya kiya? Speed up. Just two words. Speed up. And the whole day, all activities, indoor, outdoor, were about speed itself. We didn't tell them anything. Okay? And then we decided in the management, if I get an email, my response time is going to be a jiffy. Any email, which is really important for the organization, which goes out from the management to the entire floor, okay, it's going to be like that. We're going to show it in practice. When we start doing that, we didn't have to tell anything to anybody. Everybody started thinking about it where? Externally or internally? Internally. They start thinking, speed up, speed up, speed up. They start working 4 hours, 5 hours effectively. We didn't achieve 8, but our performance made a big difference. No? 3 hours to 4.5 hours, a big difference. So, one word, one phrase, one sentence. I'm sure you can pull out something from your own memory, which has made a huge impact to your life. Yes, everybody has one. One sentence. Somebody said something. My granddad. You know, I'm the most non-eligible candidate to be a coach. I'm a mechanical engineer. I'm absolutely not eligible. Right? Not qualified. Not, you know, per se, I don't have credentials to be a coach or a trainer. But my granddad, when I was a kid, said, tum jo hai na patthar se baat karoge. I don't know why he used to say that. And that remained. And that sentence used to go on, tum patthar se baat karoge. PUC tak pahunchao, do logon se dhang se baat nahi kar sakta. Ek ladki ke samne khada nahi ho sakta. Joseph's Umar bhai. So can't help it. So that used to be the state. But I said, why did he say, tum patthar se baat karoge? I said, no, I should try to speak now. He's told me that. He's already gone. Let me do something. That one phrase actually drove me to get onto the stage. Can you imagine the impact of one sentence? Can you imagine the impact of one not good sentence which is given to somebody or given to you which has created an impact? I know of somebody, I do not wish, I'm working with him at the moment, one-on-one coaching. He was a kid 4 years, fourth standard mein. He did very well in his education, in his exams. He got a good percentage. The parents were called to the school to tell that he got really good, right? Appreciate karne ke liye bulaya gaya tha. So when he was called, appreciation hone ke baad, the teacher came forward and said, he's good, but his but is a very, very powerful, you know, word, which he negates everything which was said before. See, language mein kya hota hai? Aap achhe hain, but finish. Aage piche ka pura chala gaya. Hai na? So what they said, he's good, he's done very well, but his handwriting is not good. Kid was here, father was here, unfortunately father's friend also was there. Father's friend said, he's most probably like his elder brother who has trembling of his hands. What did he say? He's following his elder brother who has trembling of his hands. That one sentence of that friend, dad's friend, remained with this kid from that day, and even today, he can't decently pick up a handphone. He trembles. It started then. He trembles. He can't straight away take a glass of water. He trembles. Alhamdulillah, it's progressing now. He's coming back out of it. We have to, you know, erase that part of it. So anyway, do you all agree to that impact of internal communication? I invite you, as a good institution, to work on this from the kids' perspective. And inshallah, we'll be able to make a big difference. I ask you a question. Recall where you wore your clothes this morning. Where did you wear your clothes this morning?
Lord's room.
Recall where you wore your clothes this morning. Bedroom. पहने हैं ना कपड़े?
बेडरूम।
You wore your clothes in the morning right now in your head. Do you understand? What has happened was in the past, but you relive that whole moment right now. And I ask you the question. That is the power of the way our system, our head processes information. So I'm going to talk a little about that. Okay? What is this? Hindi mein. So I think 3/4 of the nation sochta yahi pe hai. Isiliye hamari aisi halat ho gayi hai. Shauchalay. Hai na? For those who don't know what this word is, it's the rest room. Shauchalay, Hindi. Okay, see the power of words. If you just tweak a little, you can give up a larger communication. I just tweak this word and I'm able to communicate to people, don't go and sit there. We get nothing. A lot of people say, bathroom is solid ideas aate. A lot of people like, and that's a generalized belief. A belief, what's the definition of a belief? It's a gut feeling, which may be true or may not be true. Are you with me? Belief is different from conviction. Conviction is what? Pakka, it's my cabin doubt. Belief is phir wahan pe. Ho bhi sakta hai, nahi bhi sakta. Lekin belief ko itna yakeen kar lete hain log, that they go, that's the reason people follow everything in the world. Correct? The jhaad or the, you know, the stones or anything, they believe everything because somebody said, yeah, it happens. Right? So tweaking and twisting something in the constructs of vocabulary inside us can make a huge difference to us and to people outside. Right? So please start working on this. So speak good. Transformational vocabulary, Rasulullah has already said, speak good or remain quiet. And such a powerful thing. Speaking good aata hai jab tumhare dimag mein good chalta hai. Good andar nahi chalta hai, bahar kaise niklega? Hai na? They say the tongue is a reflection of the mind or the tongue is a reflection of the heart. So what is inside comes out. You can't control it. It has to come out. Right? So it's very important for us to know. And in the learning pyramid, lot of us focus on the top of the pyramid. But the learning maximum happens in the bottom of the pyramid. One, to teach others. What is this called? Anybody? Teach others. When you teach others something, like whatever I told you now, if you spend 2 minutes to teach somebody else, your learning goes up. To teach is to learn again. So if you see, 90% of learning increases if you teach others. And so what we need to do with our kids, teach them a concept, break, give them 10 minutes and tell them, teach your neighbor what I taught you just now. This is called a flip classroom. Have you heard of it? Flip classroom. They flip the whole classroom and they make the kids the teachers. Why? What is the wrong in getting them to teach? I take my kids who are 9, 8 and 10. When we go to the slums, we have tuition centers running in some of the slums in Bangalore. I take my kids, instead of me speaking, I put them on stage. Let them make those mistakes. Let them interact with the people. Let them interact with the kids of their age. Right? They'll make mistakes, it's fine. But they will teach. And when they teach, when they come back, the natural process is what? I taught, but I'm not practicing. Why don't I try to do it? Right? Are you with me? Yes. 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 I thought the piece. I thought people here, education people should be vibrant. Whenever you move anywhere, people should feel your presence. That's because educational industry ke jo log hote, they are on the top. They are the ones who create the prime ministers and the ministers and all that. Correct? You go even ask the ministers, aapka inspiration school mein, no, ye teacher the, ye baat bole, main aaj politician ban gaya. They would have told you, good in these things, so pursue your career. Right? So, I'm expecting a little more interaction. So I'm going to work backwards. Teach others, practice doing, discussions. This is what I would request you to spend time for the next 2 days. Don't be sitting out there just listening to Gyan. It's not going to help. Just be interactive, inshallah. So, I will leave this to you. These three things are the most important things in any learning environment. Number one is courage. How do you get courage? What's the easiest way to get courage? Shortcut. Ask? No. The best way to develop courage in children is to encourage. Encourage. That's why the word is like that. एनर्जी एंड करेज को मिलाएंगे तो एनकरेज होता है. तो हाउ डू एनकरेज? बी जेन्युइन, एनकरेज एंड आस्क देम अबाउट देयर एफर्ट्स, अप्रिशिएट देयर एफर्ट्स, दिल बी यू नो दिल गेट. द सेकंड,
कैन यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन इन बिटवीन?
नो, अ क्वेश्चन इन द लास्ट, बिकॉज़ आई हैव समथिंग टू कवर. इंशाल्लाह आई गिव यू टाइम फॉर क्वेश्चंस. सेकंड इज फ्रीडम, वेरी पावरफुल अगेन. फ्रीडम, my mom, I always, you know, she never stepped into the school, but amazing parenting. Whenever I made a mistake, she used to overlook it, because she knew this guy makes his mistakes but he will learn. She never used to pounce on me immediately, and that gave me a lot of freedom to say, yeah, I need to explore, I need to try something more. And she was like a university to me. She is a university to me even today. When my dad passed away, she didn't drop a tear. She came, sat next to me and said, you know what, she's not talking to my dad who's dead. She's telling, you know what, don't get worried, you're going to a better place. Now, that's the kind of internal communication. I said, man, what internal communication she needs to have to be able to tell like that at that situation. I said, mashallah, fantastic. You know, andar communication dhang ka nahi raha, bahar kuch bhi karo, bekar hai. To bachchon ko andar ke communication ke upar kaam karo. A lot of time, and that's not in the syllabus, neither is there in any of the syllabus. CBSE, you know, I say internal communication to par, I have never searched. When somebody who should, I encourage sisters to kuch people kar dete hain. So I encourage sisters, if anybody is pursuing PhDs, go into this internal communication part and try to write papers on it. That will make a big difference to the Ummah as well, and others also. You know, you can contribute to others. Third one is energy. Hum dheele rahenge to bacche bhi bahut dheele hain. थोड़ा हम लोग चलने का फुर्ती आना चाहिए. यू नो, एवरीथिंग इन आवर एनवायरनमेंट इज लॉट ऑफ सुस्ती इज देयर, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर मॉडलिंग अस. सो दे शुड बी, दीस थ्री एस्पेक्ट्स आर अ मैंडेट फॉर एन एजुकेशन सिस्टम. आई वांट विद मी, ब्यूटीफुल एग्जांपल, द पैराशूट कॉन्सेप्ट जो लिया है उमर भाई एंड टीम ने. आवर माइंड्स आर लाइक पैराशूट, दे फंक्शन ओनली व्हेन दे आर ओपन. क्लोज पैराशूट डोंट फंक्शन. सो आवर माइंड शुड बी ओपन टू लॉट ऑफ लर्निंग. कहीं से भी सीख सकते, दुश्मन से भी सीख सकते बोलते हैं ना. अगर कुछ अच्छी चीज मिल रही है, दुश्मन के पास वो चीज है, वो दुश्मन है, मैं क्यों सीखूं, मुझे नहीं बोल सकते. That's not the way our ego works, right? We should say, yeah, we get it. That's a good knowledge. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to distribute papers. And can you help me, sir? Can you help? So one for each, quickly. I'm keeping it open. I'm not going to give you rules of how to interact. This exercise is to get to know as many people as possible in this family. I call this as a family, because today and tomorrow you are going to be together, and we are another part of the family of a bigger Ummah. So we are family. Get to know each other. This is one of the methods how you need to get to know. So this is called bingo. Can you read out a few words there?
Use misfa. Misfa,
okay.
And like someone.
Okay.
Storyteller. Oranges, apples, mango.
Okay. So you'll have to basically get up and have the courage, have the freedom, and have the energy, enthusiasm to move around and check out as many as people as possible. Can I just hold this? To fill in at least two names in one box. So who uses miswak ke do naam aane chahiye. That means you have to interact with a lot of people to be able to get that. So you, when you interact, you talk to the person, right? You ask the name, background, and the person who finishes the whole list with at least two names in each box. Once you finish, you should shout bingo. That means the game ends there. Okay? Game ends there. I don't know about the prizes. I don't want to give you some variety addiction there. Are you with me? You have a doubt or? No. You have a question. Remember this, doubt is the worst thing for a human mind. It's always a question. Have a culture of creating questions in the children. That's the reason I asked you, do you have a doubt? You know what the English system says? Tell me your doubt, do you have any doubts? Already bol diya, doubt is tumhare dimag mein hai, sir. Question nahi hai bol ke. Are you with me? You have a doubt? Yes, just a question.
No,
no, you have to go around everywhere. You have come into the program now. Now don't exclude yourself from the program. Go around, and talk to people, you're already in your niqab and hijabs, no problem, alhamdulillah. Go around, talk to people and get their likes and dislikes, whatever they are saying. So the moment you get one name, say for example, has been to Hajj. So if somebody has been to Hajj, you get the confirmation, write their name. Do naam, ek box mein. Theek hai? And I'm giving you limited time. बाबा उठ के जाना है, इसे बैठ के नहीं करना, ये सुस्ती हो जाएगी. Wherever we are, Islam is not about being in comfort, by the way. Run around the hall and get those names. The moment you get the whole thing, say bingo. Please don't sit. This is the worst thing you can do, is to sit down. Please move. Sisters, please get up. Ujjay, please get up. Get up. Please get up. Yeah, yahin pe mat kijiye, adjustment. Please get up. Move around. Okay, nahi, I'm not allowed to sit down. Please get up. Move around. That's the intent of this. Please move. No sitting down. Move, please. The moment you fill in the page, you can shout out bingo.
Make a circle. Choose a leader.
My dear brothers, my loving brothers, come here, please, sir. Come here. My dear sisters, please choose a leader in the team. Quickly, make a circle. Choose a leader in the men.
Yes, I'll be the leader.
Okay, now you are going to facilitate the bingo through using the whole team. Right away. I don't know how you're going to do it. Go forward. Be a circle. Make a circle. Make a complete circle. Full circle.
Do you want some
sisters? Sisters, have you chosen the leader? Who's the leader here? Team leader.
So.
Okay. You are going to facilitate a bingo from your team.
Square.
We'll now it is men against
the
women.
Someone in the first square.
Okay. We'll see who gets the
first square. Do someone in first square, second square, third square, fourth square, or fourth,
we have women, Shetty
from
Sade.
Okay, fifth square.
Okay, this is against the men versus the women now. Guys, come on, yes. Let's have the bingo.
Fifth square, seventh square, swimming, yes, swimming.
Swimming,
women,
Shetty from Sade. Join. There's one more extra form. Extra form,
right?
Not there. Share the form.
Sixth square, Imran and Umar.
See, also you are setting a lot of goals here, right? Indirectly. So we need to create activities like this for kids so that they can come directly and indirectly. We are too learning.
Bingo!
Okay, we got the bingo here.
Ask three doctors.
Yes, doctor. Check.
Sisters, it's over. They got the bingo. Let's settle down. Please settle down. Quick.
The men are smarter.
I'm going to quote you.
So we need a good breakfast, some pieces.
You want a tea break?
Good tea.
That's the nuffs here.
The men are the winners.
After every hard work, we always want something. You know? Subhanallah. So what stopped us from doing the getting together as a team in the starting? Nobody thought of it. Nobody stepped in to take lead. Hey guys, hey girls, let's talk, let's get into together and start, you know, shortly. How fast you did it afterwards, right? Otherwise you would have gone on for the next 10-15 minutes, you wouldn't have been able to get the bingo. Are you with me on that? So always, when you're engaging on the management, involve a lot of people for shura. You get the best inputs. Sometimes things which you don't even imagine can come from there. So that's one of the learnings, inshallah, here. So there are two kinds of people in this world, and this is proven. They are the 20% and the 80%. So the probability of finding an 80% is more higher, right? In the community, in the society, right? So there are traits of these people. This is called the Pareto's principle. It does not matter what it is called. But what makes these people? There is something called as emotional intelligence, there is something called as mental health, spiritual quotient and physical being. There are so many areas we have got. But what is the underlying factor, one of the factors which is the direct cause for people to maintain a very solid, vibrant attitude in despite of all conditions? And some people who are all the time, even if they have the best condition, they are always crying, complaining and blaming. What makes that? So this is called vocabulary, internal vocabulary impact. It has been seen, so we will work about this whole word called the state. Maintaining the state has two sides. You can be either in resourceful or an unresourceful state. At the moment you all are resourceful state, right? You just did an activity, you moved around, you did a lot of good thing, right? So you are in a resourceful state. When we get angry or when we get upset, we are in an unresourceful state. What happens in an unresourceful state? We are not able to solve things. Resourceful state, you're vibrant, you think. And iman is about resourceful state, right? An iman cannot rest inside a soul which is depressed, which is down. Are you with me? Sisters, are you able to understand my language? Is it clear? So I need a louder yes.
Yes.
Teachers, people who are associated with education industry should have a very loud voice. If you don't have one, practice. Practice to have that. It helps. So now let's see what happens and how this whole thing is created. Our brains, let me look at this. What is this? It's a blank screen. I'll give you one input to your computers there. One input. Let's see what it processes. Don't think about your mother. What happened? Huh? What happened? Immediately. What does it say? It says that language is very uniquely processed in the brain. Negative atas nahi. Don't. What does it say? It says that brain processes visuals 60,000 faster, 60,000 times faster than text. Matlab kya? Don't think about a pink donkey. Zindagi mein apne pink donkey dekha nahi, lekin visual aa gaya. Hai na? P-I-N-K, D-O-N-K, E-Y-N-K. Don't think about a pink donkey smiling. You're getting the visual? I'm saying you not to do it and you're doing it. Don't touch the candle. Bacche ko bole to kya karta? Don't shout bole to kya karta? Class mein. Huh? We have become a world and an ummah of don'ts. Do karne ke liye bolo. Candy ke taraf ja raha hai to bete, is taraf aao, please pick that glass of water and give me. Ho gaya, you have diverted the kid from there. You understand? Linguistic patterns are so powerful in education. Don't ki zaban thoda chhod ke, do ki zaban ke taraf aaiye. Because I saw the word, the brain processes stuff. So the moment I say pentagon, you don't get P-E-N-T-A-G-O-N. It comes in the form of an image, right? And for some, it comes like this. The moment I say pentagon, bolte kya hota hai? The building pentagon aata hai. So it is image and it is different for everybody. So we need to start understanding, bachchon ke andar mere words ke wajah se kya visuals chal rahe hain. The moment I tell my third son, don't, he is faster than me in doing it. So we reverse the whole thing. Whatever we want him to do, we say don't. Got it? Don't go to the class today, bete. So we go nako jao. Amai jao. Amai jao. So when you understand and gauge what triggers are creating actions and behaviors in children, you will be managing. Otherwise, he will be managing you. And you cannot do anything about it. Are you with me? Make sense? So what you need to do? You need to be observant about some good, some images don't have, some words don't have images. Because there's so much of it in the market. So what, the first distinction is, what is this? Do you know what incantations are? What is incantation? Tasbih ko bolte hain incantation. Kya bolte hain? Tasbih. Why is tasbih recommended? Why is it so powerful? Just to do it and leave it? It has an internal impact. Right? I am sitting with my wife on the table having khana. She says, I need salt. I get up. She is tired. She has worked the whole day. So I say, okay, I'll support. I get up. Go into the kitchen. As I'm going, I start off, I don't know where the salt is. She says, there's salt. I said, where's the salt? She said, go there. Go inside the kitchen. There's a cupboard. Right side ka cupboard hai. Top shelf, left corner, last bottle with the yellow lid. So I go, I don't know where she's kept it. This is what is going on inside my internal conversation. I don't know where the salt is. I don't know where the salt is. And I go, I look, last shelf, top shelf, last corner. See, I can't see it. Where is the salt? She said, I told you, top shelf, left corner, last bottle with the yellow lid. And I say, I can't see it. She gets tired, gets up and comes, stands right next to me and says, what is this? I didn't see it. It is right there. Has happened to you?
Yes.
It's not that women are more smarter. Sorry. It's because I incantated something so much that I started believing that it's not there. This is called scotoma. Blind spot hota hai, brain ke andar. which activates on something which you tell repeatedly. The more you tell something, it activates. So we need to understand in vocabulary, internal vocabulary, incantations can be very dangerous. Hamare jo usual vocabulary chalte hai andar, nahi theek nahi, I am not that good. That all creates a belief. It has an impact. So look at converting all those negative incantations to probable, possible, positive ones. There could be a possibility, right? There was a kid who was in the mathematics class in Harvard, and he was very tired last period of the day. Maths, I told his example quite a number of times because it's a very crucial, important example for the system, education system. The professor comes in, he's teaching maths. He sees the kid sleeping. He's tired and he's sleeping. So he allows him to sleep and he continues the class. The class ends, the bell or whatever goes off, people get up and start running outside. This guy gets up and looks at the board and says, God, don't tell me. Two equations I have to take as homework. He writes down the equations, takes it back, freshens up at home, starts working it out, and he struggles and struggles and struggles. 3 a.m. he's able to solve, sleeps, comes back to the class next day. Mathematics class, the professor says, so everybody, how are you all? This guy puts up his hand and says, I've completed the assignment. Professor looks, what? Bring me your book. This guy gets the book. Professor goes through it again and again and again, slumps into the chair and says, I cannot believe it. You have solved two of the most difficult equations in the maths world, unsolvable for past 30 years. The kid is shocked. I thought this is homework. So what is it I'm trying to tell you? What do you get out of this example?
Believe you can.
Why did he do it?
He thought it is possible.
Come on, give me a substance answer. Give me a substance. This is a very important thing.
Because this part is very important. It's a common question that I can solve.
He thought like that. How? Yes, sister.
He never heard that it is unsolvable.
Absolutely right. What does that mean? Even one statement can create a belief. You don't have to build it over a period of time. Somebody's opinion, the lecturer, what he said, he put the two equations and this guy was sleeping. He told the class, these two equations, unsolvable for the past 30 years, everybody believed it. They didn't try. This guy was sleeping. He said, homework. So, yakeen, ek sentence se bhi ho sakta hai. Mind your sentences, otherwise resign from being in this position. It's a very responsible position. Mind yourself, one sentence can create an impact for a kid for life. One sentence can make the kid for life. Itna cautious hona chahiye, hai na? As parents, as well as teachers. So an opinion creates a belief. A belief naturally creates an action. We have to act. Once we have something in our heart and mind, we act. The moment we act, we have a result, and then the cycle of belief starts. This is what happens, right? So that when it's built over a period of time leads to conviction. This is the crux of the whole nervous system. This is how we work. This is the engine of the nervous system. So what are the kind of common statements we either have for ourselves or we have as an opinion for others? I can't. I'm unlucky. I'm lazy. I'm a late Latif. I'm a slow learner. She doesn't understand me. I'm fat. I come from a poor background. I'm angry man. I have a short fuse, I'm not good, whatever, blah, blah, look at that. All these incantated or spoken can have an impact on our entire belief system itself. So the distinction, second distinction is, the first one was?
Incantation.
Second one is? A tone, intensity of the tone also matters. So when we tell something which is very negative, how do we tell, what's the tone it has usually? Inside our mind also, what's the tone it has? It has a very convincing tone. Can you take that? You know, when somebody wants to tell something positive, it's a very dhila tone. I can't do it. It's a good khair you have to actually do. I must do it. Can I bolte kon bhi andar? Kya bolte? Dekhenge, hoga to karenge. The tone itself is very unconvincing. Whereas if you say, I'm an idiot, how do I say that? Yes, I'm an idiot. I know that. The whole world knows that. Can you see? Tone matters also, internal and external. If, for example, if the mother says to the child, I hate you, what happens to the kid? What happens? He's broken, right? Same thing, I hate you. What happens? The kid knows that the mother loves. Khali, sentence kya bhi change nahi kara hum, words kya bhi change nahi kara, khali uska tone change kara, pura feeling change ho gaya. So we have to be very cautious about the intensity. So moderate your intensity. Find out a good way of moderating your intensity of tone. If it is a convincing tone, which is negative, scramble it. How do you scramble it? This is for our own self. If I have a convincing tone saying, don't tell me that, I am no good, say, I'm not. Change the tone. Represent it like that, so that it does not have an impact on your belief. So that slowly it dissolves. I'm telling you this because I work with a lot of people who are stuck with a small sentence for life. And they're not able to come out of it. And it's a silly sentence usually. And it's very convincing to that person. So you need to work with that. So when you're working with kids, you can also check out what is the sentence in the background which is running. Sometimes the child blurts it out. So you should catch it, be sensitive. Passive tone. Passive matlab jo dhile irade hote hain. Andar dhile hi nazar aate hain. Aarena, definitely aarena seminar. Inshallah mai aata. That shows inshallah tala. Not inshallah tala. So be careful about that tones. What do you see here? Quick, be responsive here. AC nikal denge kya? Thandi zyada hogi. What do you see here? Two people sitting. More specific, please. A couple sitting. So our brains are very assumptive. You should have said, I cannot tell you until you show me the front. Right? That's the way our professor has taught. चेक 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 उसके बाद हमें क्या करते हैं व्हाट्सएप में आते हैं टाका 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 फॉरवर्ड करके फिनिश पूरा हजामत होने के बाद सोचते अरे कहीं करना नहीं था यार है ना व्हाट्सएप ही नहीं बोलो जिंदगी में भी ऐसा ही होता है द गॉसिप्स व्हाट हैपेंस इट्स नॉट अबाउट बिजनेस एंड वी पोक आवर नोज दिस इज अ कल्चर वी नीड टू टीच आवर किड्स अजम्पशंस नहीं होना चाहिए अजम्पटिव बिहेवियर कैन लीड टू लॉट ऑफ डिजास्टर There was a very, very big magician. I don't know if you know his name. Know this person by name, Houdini Pulki. He was a master of escape. तो उसको ऐसे locks में डालके छोड़ते थे. तो Jiffy he used to break the locks. It was very powerful. He used to put chains, throw them into water. He used to come out in Jiffy. So the UK prison authority. This is a story I've heard. UK prison authorities challenged him. They said our prisons are unbreakable. If you get into the prison, you will not be able to come out. He said, what are you talking? The most complicated locks in the world I have broken. This is nothing. So they put him inside the biggest cell, you know, the one which is the strong cell. Usme dalke usko, they closed the door. And this man started working. Media was there, people are there, everybody is waiting. He's going to finish and come out. Bolke, ek ghanta, do ghante, teen ghante. Pura din gaya. There's no food, no water for him there. He worked the whole night. Next morning, absolutely exhausted. On the verge of giving up, he fell onto the door and the door opened. The door wasn't locked. The people in the intelligence in the UK prisons said, lock raha to usne khol sakta hai, lock nahi raha to kya khol. And the doors are heavy, huge. So aksar jo locks duniya ke hote hain, hame aise nazar aata hai ki wo haqeeqat hai. Lekin the lock is inside us, it's not outside. So where we should need to work as a community, where we should build strength internally first, that's when it will reflect automatically outside. And we don't have any system which helps us build internal strength in the education system. So it's an open opportunity for everybody to think and say, let's develop a parallel curriculum which complements whatever is there here, so that we build kids which have a mind of their own. Today you ask a kid who's into a second PUC, what do you want to do? Full confused. It's good to be confused, but in that confusion, they should have a couple of clarity at least. There's nothing there. You always want to ask fully. My friends are going here, I'm going here. So, assumptions need to be worked on. A kid's mind with a lot of assumptions can be a disaster, and Shaitan works on assumptions, right? So, try to get the truth in every aspect. Work towards getting the truth. We are human, we make errors. But we can minimize, right? assumptions minimize kar sakte hain. Work on the truth, assume good. The other thing is hamara dimag assume is karte rehta, because it's habituated to assume. So start assuming good. If somebody has not kept up an appointment, think about kya to hoga, alhamdulillah, let him take it easy and reach on whenever he can, and I will not feel bad about it. You are assuming, but instead of assuming what irresponsible guy he is, because once he comes, your reaction will be according to your assumption. If a husband doesn't come home early, if a wife assumes wrong, she's going to react. It's a natural behavior. If the husband expects something from the wife and the wife doesn't do, he's going to assume, and there's a reaction. So that's how we need to work. Our minds are more precious than anything else in this world. It's one of the biggest gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't want to work on our mind, we want to work on other people's mind. Wow! That's the biggest irony I can think of. Assume favorably. Favorite to others. Ninnanve agar galtiyan bhi dikh rahi hain, to give another chance to the brother. That's what he said. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who you have believed, avoid negative assumptions. Indeed, some assumption is sin. And it leads to what? Discontent, conflict, breakdowns, hatred, jealousy, prejudice, politics, stress, inefficiency, all that is there in the system. Can't build karna system hai. Education system ke andar ye nahi build karenge, to aap kya ABCD sikhayenge? Kya number sikhayenge? Kahan hai robust system where it demonstrates that in this organization there is no space for assumptions. I have a friend in Turkey, he runs 16 businesses. I asked him, brother, how do you run 16 businesses? It's crazy. He said, you are kanjus. Tumna business run karne nahi aata. English mein bole. You don't know how to run the business. You have to run 15 business minimum. I've taken on 16 just now. I said, how do you do that? Because we have run it with a principle. I said, what's that principle? There's only one principle inside the entire organization. If somebody comes and tells me about somebody else, he's a liar. If somebody comes and tells about somebody else in the organization to me, he is a liar. Alas. So nobody has a choice of. That's the rule. They have made that as a statement. So nobody dares to go and tell anything wrong about others. Smooth flow. If he does, anybody does, he's fired. Somebody comes and tells about somebody else to him or anybody else, he's fired. Finish. End of the day. He's out. He's given the pink slip and said, we don't need you here. I'm getting my point. कितना फितना करते हैं हम लोग इनका भाई इनकी बात उनको उनकी बात इनको एक तो गुनाह है वो गुनाह किस लिए बिकॉज इट क्रिएट्स अ फितना दैट्स द रीजन सो आवर सिस्टम्स व्हिच आर देयर वी टॉक सो मच अबाउट इस्लाम एंड ऑल बट वेयर इज इट इन इंप्लीमेंटेशन इंप्लीमेंट कहां करते हैं मैनेजमेंट लेवल पे इंप्लीमेंट करते हैं एक दूसरे की बिकरिंग हो रही है एक डायरेक्टर इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द अदर डायरेक्टर हाउ कैन यू रन इट हाउ विल द बरका ऑफ अल्लाह कम देन ऑल थ्योरी में रहता है Practical, you have to put it in action, right? So put firm values in the management before you do anything. That will make a big difference in the way the entire culture of the institution is going to run. And some of these values I just expressed to you. And I put below. Do you have cheap ears? If somebody is coming and telling you something about somebody else, you're going to give the ear? You have to stand up and say, please don't talk. He might be the worst person on earth. Don't talk. Don't talk about it. I don't want to listen. If this is what we found our institutions, inshallah. So before we end, I want you to pick up a challenge which you have. Current challenge. Or a goal which you're struggling with. Current challenge, goal, jo bhi bolo. Just pick up one for your experiment. I'm just going to lead you through. And take your notepads and answer these questions pertaining to that challenge. आपको चैलेंज है आपके जिंदगी में गोल करना अचीव करना चाहते हैं ओके उसके बारे में वो गोल हो नहीं रहा है इट्स अ चैलेंज स्टिल आपको चैलेंज स्टेट में ही है यू स्टिल स्ट्राइविंग टू गेट दैट कंप्लीटेड ओके सो नाउ आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज रॉन्ग एंड राइट द आंसर डिड यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन सो अबाउट दैट गोल और दैट चैलेंज लिखिए what is wrong, write down. Second, why do I have this challenge? Answer, write the answer, it's important to write. And education industry के अंदर लिखना बहुत जरूरी है टाइप करना कम जरूरी है लिखना is important. Second question kya hai? Why do I have this challenge? Write the answer. Third question, how long do I have this challenge? Write the answer. Fourth question, how does this limit me? This challenge which you are undergoing, how does this limit? And this could be a professional, personal challenge, does not matter. Take up the challenge. How does this whole challenge limit me? What does this problem or challenge stop me from doing? Whose fault it is that I have this challenge? Done? Done or no? Answer to answer mujhe samajh mein nahi aayega. Done? Okay. Writing is a little difficult art today. Mushkil hota hai likhna. Because we have lost it. Pura typing mein chal raha hai. WhatsApp to issa fast jata hai abhi, baap re. Zoom, like you know, it's that, got the drag also. I don't know how they do it. Take a deep breath. When you're writing, you need oxygen. Tell kids always to take a deep breath. Once in the teachers especially, the class chalti rehti hai. Because 40 minutes is the attention span for a child. In between, tell them to take a couple of deep breaths consciously. Like that. Take a deep breath, bolo, bachchon. Let them make it like an activity. It's good. Because pure oxygen to milta hi nahi. You're done? Do activities fast so that you can also promote kids to do these. These are not critical activities. It has to be done quickly and fast and you have to move forward. Done? Yes or no?
Yes.
How many haven't done? Okay, jaldi karo bhai. Sisters done? Just write bulleted likho. Zyada lambi tafsir ki zarurat nahi. Just bullet. Done? Sisters, done? Okay. So pause now. Take a deep breath. How did you feel writing this? How did you feel writing this? Huh? Was challenging. What else? What? How did you feel? I am asking feel. We should be in touch with our feelings. We are not in touch with it. Emotional intelligence kya bolte hai? It's about understanding that today I am upset. When you realize that, then you can work on it. Now I am angry. You can the moment you realize, you can work. You don't. Once I had gone about 15, 18 years back, I went to a doctor and I started talking. The doctor said, you are very stressed. I got angry on him. Who the hell told you I am stressed? How do you know I am shouting at him and he is smiling at me. You are stressed, he said. I said, no, you don't. I am never stressed. And I'm fighting it out. I'm telling you, I'm not stressed. He's saying, yes, you're stressed. Please sit down. So, awareness is the first step. Right? How did you feel doing this? You need to be in touch with yourself. How did you feel doing this?
Unloading.
Unloading, okay.
It was difficult.
It was slightly uncomfortable. Painful. Right? Okay, take another deep breath. Now, next set. Same challenge बोल लो और ये answer करो next sheet पे ये same sheet पे मत करना next sheet पे करना what do I want same challenge okay what do I want when do I want it जो भी challenge आपने लिया first set of questions जो answer करे same challenge के ऊपर ये next set of questions answer कीजिए what do I want When do I want it? How will I know when I have it? Pertaining to your goal and challenge. When I get it, what else will change? What are the resources I have available to help me to overcome this challenge? bulleted formats will you? Bullets will you? So that it's easier for you. What resources do I have available to help me? Last question is, what am I going to do right now to break this challenge or to overcome this challenge? Confident, correct? What else?
Productive.
You are seeing, you are productive. You are feeling productive now. You are feeling the control has come back to you. Earlier was, control was not there with you, right? This is one of the most profound thing about our brains. Let's see if your brains are working. 2 plus 2? 2 plus 8? See, the moment I did not ask you to answer. Did I ask you to answer? I said, let's see whether your brains are working. I said, 2 plus 2, you answered. Everybody knows it's 4. Why did you answer? Huh? Because the format of the brain, the working structure of the brain is like that. It loves questions. What does it do? Processing kaisa hota hai? Sawal se process hota hai. Not statement se sawal hai. Ye nahi hota, process nahi hota. Hamara dimag sawal se process hota hai. Aur hum log kya karte hain? We are experts in asking the wrong questions to ourselves. Why am I fat? What answers will you get? You are irresponsible, you don't have any seriousness, you have bad habits, taka taka taka. Kaun answer de rahe? Hamara khud dimag deta answer. Ek sawal do, 10 galat. Ek galat sawal, 10 galat jawab aate. So the quality of your life and my life is the quality of questions I ask myself. First pure quality of questions are wrong. This is called a blame frame. Frames hote hai dimag ke andar. Ye kya hai ye? Blame frame बोलते हैं इसके अंदर कोई भी ढंग का क्वेश्चन नहीं है what is wrong what will you do asking that question it's of no use who is it for whose fault it is to have this challenge people love to blame themselves I only it's a blame frame whereas the other one is the people the 20% is बोले ना मैं बोला ना 80% are the people who ask questions like this in life if at all there's something wrong in your lives or wrong in the systems in your institution, it's because everybody is using what? Blame frame. Have you ever noticed, there's a meeting going on, there's a lot of blaming going on. Ye kyun nahi hua, wo kaisa nahi hua, wo kaan nahi hua, ye kya? There's a blame frame going on. Suddenly the leader stands up and says, all done, ab aage kya karna bolo? Outcome frame. It's called, live in the outcome frame, your life will be much lighter, much proactive, productive and you will be in control. And Allah has given that control to us. We don't want to take it. We want to keep blaming. Blaming leads to what? Extreme blaming leads to kufr, they say. Right? And being in the outcome frame leads to you being in control. Then Allah has given that control to us. We don't want to take that control. And this is blame and this is outcome. See, every question is so productive there. Quality of question you ask is the quality of life. If there's any issue in your life, don't blame others. It's the way you are running your question inside your head. So this is a very powerful distinction. 80% of the people ask wrong questions to themselves. That's why they mess up. So I invite you to having a more productive outcome framed quality of life, telling that, okay, it's not ho gaya, what can I do now? How can I do it? In that way, you will be able to transform the entire system inside your institution, inshallah. So, I think my time's up. Jazakallah khair for bearing me patiently here. If I've said anything which has not been okay with you all, throw it away. If I've said anything which is useful to you, inshallah, use it. I'll be available. You can connect me through Brother Umar, inshallah. Anything required for teachers or... In fact, the book which I have written, I request you to pick it up because there's a lot of transformational vocabulary I have explained inside that book. And I'm not trying to sell this book because alhamdulillah all the prophets are going to the slum. All the prophets from the book go to our centers. We run something called as Ants to Giants mentoring center. Some of the people are a part of it here as well. So do pick up a book. Inshallah, it will be a good guide to you. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Thank you. You're waiting here. Not going anywhere. We have time just for one question. Anyone has a question related to this session?
Somebody had a question.
You, the brother, you have a question.
Yeah.
Yes.
In your talk, you said that you have to encourage the students. But should we have a limit on encouraging the students because if it goes beyond?
Use truth as your balance. Sachai use karo, it is easy. So if you do fake encouragement, that leads to a lot of mess for the kid itself. Because the kid will know, I didn't do so well. They are encouraging me, so there's a conflict there. So it's better to be truthful and encourage the effort. Great effort going. Don't encourage the person. Hum log kya karte hai, when we put somebody down or we want to correct somebody, I'll give an example. Like my son, for example, did something. My eldest son, Izhan, he did something wrong. I say, Izhan, you are stupid. Correct? That's the usual thing. You're a fool. Right? But see the difference. I'll give you another difference. Izhan did something wrong. Izhan, what you did is really stupid. Big difference, right? First one, I'm implicating his identity. Uske personality ke upar hi bol raha hu, you are stupid boy. Second one, the intensity is the same because it's a mess. The intensity is the same, but my language is very different. What you did is stupid. He'll say, what, you called me stupid? I'll say, no, I didn't call you stupid. I called, because they come back like that. I called what action you did was not right. You are fantastic, but this action which you did is not right. So that way the feedback should be very correct. So I'm encouraged. You know, we should always tell what you did. Your efforts were really good. MashaAllah.
Okay. And just actually, speak good or remain silent. Was that the motivation for you to build this whole training session workshop? How were you inspired to do this?
I was in a mess, brother.
Right.
18 years back, I was in a mess. I was on the road beating up a driver and my wife is sitting.
Road rage.
2 days prior to that, we married. And I'm in the car, and the auto driver tha lagake gaya. So I get down and beat up the auto driver. My wife said, who did I marry? Qualified engineer hai, sab acha hai. And then she said, no, there's something wrong with you. I couldn't take it. So after that, I started doing. So there's something wrong with me, is what she said.
So it's years of experience and learning.
Yeah,
So you've conducted this lot of workshops of this kind in various places,
yes,
or organizations, or your own now.
I've learned from a lot of people,
right,
both inside the country and outside. I prefer to travel out because there's a lot of, West has done a lot of research on language, linguistic stuff, vocabulary pay. They've segmented it, they've understood. There are different models if you want to, go and Google Milton model of language. These are very powerful language. They're hypnotic languages. A lot of people have this misconception that hypnosis means the watch ko aisa aisa ghumate. घुमाते लोगों को सुला के उनके पास कुछ कुछ काम कराते हुए दैट इज अल्लाह वालम दैट मे बी मैजिक एंड समथिंग एल्स बट एक्चुअली पीपल यूज लैंग्वेज टू कंट्रोल अदर्स वी नीड टू बी केयरफुल अबाउट दैट यू नो रिटन लैंग्वेज दैट पीपल यूज टू कंट्रोल अदर्स ट्रेंड्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड लाइक आई सेड बोर वन वर्ड दे इंट्रोड्यूस एंड चेंज द एंटायर कल्चर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड सो वी हैव टू बी अपडेटेड विद द लैंग्वेज पैटर्न्स व्हिच दीस पीपल आर डिस्कवरिंग ब्रिंगिंग आउट एंड ट्राइंग टू फॉर्मेट आई थिंक वी नीड टू डू इट सो हमारे अंदर इंजीनियर्स होते हैं डॉक्टर्स होते हैं आर्ट्स में कौन भी नहीं जाते लिंग्विस्टिक्स में कौन भी नहीं जाते करियर लिंग्विस्टिक्स में भी काफी है साइकोलॉजी के अंदर कितना करियर है वी डोंट इवन एनकरेज आवर किड्स टू टेक अप साइकोलॉजी साइकोलॉजी इज हाईएस्ट पेड इन यूएस यू नो दैट हाईएस्ट पेड सो डिस्कवर इट्स बेसिकली गोइंग आउट एंड ट्राइंग टू बी अ लर्नर देयर
सर एज यू सेड माशाल्लाह आई मीन देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट इट वाज एन अमेजिंग सेशन विद द पावर ऑफ द वर्ड ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल वोकैबुलरी यू जस्ट पुट इट इन द राइट कॉन्टेक्स्ट So can you also have, as you said at the start, do you want to take something from this?
Yeah.
And so is it possible for, say, individual institutions or schools to invite you?
Sure.
And conduct something more specific to their needs or concerns?
Sure, we can.
It's possible. So this is one, inshallah. In fact, we'll be taking this also in a summary later on in the evening. We will ask you what you learned from this session as such. So inshallah, we look forward to inshallah having you and interacting more with our participants on an individual level and doing some kind of a training for them in a more customized way as well. Barakallahu feek. Okay, that was really amazing. Jazakallahu khair.
Positive vocabulary.
So can you just, again, positive vocabulary in their individual institutions. How can they use this? Brief and short.
Do you, in the institution, do you have something called as a vision? Okay. Generally, institutions have vision, mission, and values. Okay, whatever is written in the vision, mission, is just for the sake of the website. Are you with me? I challenge, if I ask you what is the vision of your school, college, you will not be able to read it out. Right? So vision, mission, values, kya waste banaye? So these vision and mission and values must be a positive driving force for the entire culture of the institution. It should be so vibrant that everybody knows, even the kids should know, what are the three values in this school. उसको डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन में लाना चाहिए एटलीस्ट वो थ्री वैल्यूज उन्हें प्रैक्टिस बच्चा प्रैक्टिस किया स्कूल के अंदर 10 साल उसकी जिंदगी में वो तीन वैल्यूज नहीं छोड़ता मैं इंशाल्लाह
मिशन विजन एंड
वैल्यूज थ्री थिंग्स एंड दिस इज नॉट प्रोफेशनली डन बाय आवर इंस्टीट्यूशंस दे जस्ट डू इट दिल में जो आया तीन लोग बैठते हैं मिशन कर दो विजन मिशन एंड वैल्यूज लिख दो लिख के वो वेबसाइट में डाल दो उसके बाद खली वली वी डोंट वांट टू नो अबाउट So please be conscious because it's a commitment. It's like a covenant. Vision, the covenant. And the values is the culture you're going to send. So make it very vibrant, positive. As I said, speed up bolke ek value hum log hamare organization mein laaye. Culture pura change ho raha hai. Everybody became faster and...
Okay, fine. So mission, vision and values. Akhi, values. Now how would that differ from your mission and vision? Why do you matter values? Normally we just say mission and vision.
Yeah, values is something you will never compromise.
So they have to be Islamic and Quran, Sunnah and so on.
See, values are common to the whole world. If you talk about honesty, nobody is going to reject that.
Right.
Even an atheist will not reject honesty. You know? That's the beauty about values. If you start pronouncing values, everybody will accept it. Sure. So there are 2-3 values. 7-10 values dikhte log, wo practice nahi hota. Teen kare, laser focus. What is laser? It's light amplified, right? Light is dispersed. The moment you bring it together and amplify it, it becomes laser, it cuts through metal. So value should be like that, that there should not be any doubt about the value itself. It should be so focused, low teen values rakhna, compromising nahi kar sakte. For example, sincerity of value rakhe, ikhlas. So when you have that value there, the kid will start understanding what the value is. He will start thinking about the value. The management will think about the value. The teachers will think. So it becomes a culture to talk about sincerity. Until you don't talk about it, you will never know it. If you don't know it, how will you implement it?
Okay. And so positive vocabulary with mission, vision, values, this is one complete learning, at least minimum. Okay, second point. Yes.
Positive incantation.
Yeah, tasbih. Yeah.
Tasbih. Okay, so we'll put this down. Next point. Then again, positive incantations, whether as individuals or within their schools, how do they use it?
For example,
as teachers, so let's ask teachers.
So, give me a negative vocabulary which we often use. School we use something? स्कूल में उर्दू मत यूज कीजिए उर्दू हमारे घर की जो है निकल के कम्स इनटू दी सो आई हैड टू रिमूव वन ऑफ माय सन्स फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द स्कूल्स बिकॉज़ द टीचर वाज स्पीकिंग हाफ उर्दू एंड हाफ इंग्लिश एंड देन मोस्ट ऑफ द किड्स वर टॉकिंग इन उर्दू एंड माय सन हु नेवर न्यू दखनी उर्दू बिकेम एन एक्सपर्ट इन दखनी उर्दू एंड उर्दू सॉन्ग आई मीन हिंदी सॉन्ग्स सो इनकैंटेशन इज समथिंग वी ऑफन टॉक फॉर एग्जांपल We have three values in our school. I'm connecting values to incantation. Three values. Imagine in the morning when you start the class, you talk about the three values before even you start your lesson. It's a positive incantation. You're doing it every day, every class. The teacher starts
the day or this lesson by the three values of our school is sincerity, hard work and speed. Three values dali. So what does sincerity mean to me? Where am I implementing sincerity? Hard work, speed. So three things you already told how many times in a day? Jitne bhi class hote hain utne time bole. So bachcha ko kya hota? This is a positive incantation for him. Even if he dislikes it, he has to think about it. His internal communication, instead of having something wrong, has something already good. There's a big chance that he will start looking at these values as important values.
Okay, so, so teachers, in your schools, in your class, positive vocabulary, positive incantations. Mashallah. Yes, Dr. Sen.
So all these things have to be put into practice.
Right.
When the situation arises, when there is a fight between parent and a teacher, how do you deal? When a child and a mother is in anger.
Excellent. Super. Very good question. I know Zaid sir has put the question properly to me, knowing the answer also. That's the beauty about some people. You know, they want the knowledge to.
So give me one word for it as an answer.
What you said is, when a fight happens, which is the frame you are in? My question to you people. We spoke about two frames, right? Which is the first frame? Blame frame, right? So when there's a fight happening, which frame is predominantly there? The questions which are going on are in blame frame. So you will lead the other person only if you are in outcome frame. Apne sawal ko aap apne pehle correct karenge to you will say, okay, done, ye ho gaya. This is all the challenges we had. Now let's get into action. What do you suggest is the right thing to do? You ask the person who's creating the fitna. You say, what do you think is the right thing to do? You suggest, we will see what. So that person also will get into an outcome frame and starts, he'll put
so,
the fight.
So can you give me something like these two words? So they can
outcome frame. Move from blame frame to outcome frame. All the while. If there's a fight happening, it's because two people are involved in a blame frame. That's the only reason.
Fine. So alhamdulillah, we have the 3 points. I mean, you can go on and on with this learning. Because of the restriction of time, inshallah. So let's move on to the next session.
Jazakallah, thank you.
Join us.